body image.
You just saw is considered by many to be controversial, opinionated, and maybe even a little strange. All of which he is, along with being a father, a musician, a composer, and I think a genius. Anything else, he can tell you himself. I'd like you to meet Frank Zappa.
Frank, welcome to Livewire.
Really a pleasure to have you here.
This is different.
Yeah, it is different. And so are you. I mean, you are what you is. People have been putting a lot of labels on you for a long time, from outrageous to obscene. Mm-hmm. Especially the latter. What on those labels, do you think they're fair?
Well, the matter of obscenity is that's a legal question, not even a matter of fairness. Uh-huh. And I think that Americans pay far too much attention and spend far too much money trying to legislate the way people talk. Mm-hmm. I think it's a waste of time. And I think that if you can speak the English language, you have the right to use any word in that language. the best way you know how to get your point across to somebody else, and especially if you're in the arts. You should have the right to say what you have to say the best way you can say it without having to worry about wending your way through the regulations right. that the government has set up to stand in your way.
Yeah.
And so if somebody calls me obscene, the only thing that means to me is just another business problem that I have to deal with.
Right.
That's all.
Okay. See, secularius on it. Right. Tell me about, you have had an image over the years. I mean, a lot of people have frozen you with Mothers of Invention, and you've certainly come a long way since then.
Oh, about 20 years.
About 20 years, exactly. Have you worked on an image? Is that something you've cultivated to help you as an artist that can help you publicly?
No, I haven't. In fact, I had to do very little work in that regard. If there's anything that I have to do about my image is try and straighten people out when they associate me with things like drugs and certain types of behavior that I definitely am not involved in.
People
just presume that because I look this way, they think, oh boy, this guy has got to be, on something.
And we're talking cocaine here, right. No, it's not the case.
No, I don't use any drugs.
Is that right? And it's never been associated with you, either. The something I just heard the London Symphony Orchestra, one of your compositions, wonderful album, that I had no idea that you had moved in that direction. And it's dynamite. I think people have also frozen you back with hard guitar riffs and so forth, and you really...
Well, the thing is that I didn't just go in that direction. That's where I started. I was writing orchestral music and chamber music before I ever got into rock and roll. And the reason I went into rock and roll is because I kept sending my scores to orchestras, and they wouldn't play them. So I said, if I'm going to write music and I want to hear what I write, I'm going to have to get somebody to play it, even if they're rock and roll musicians. So I put the band together.
Yeah.
But the things that were released on that album, which came out in January, have been written over a period of years. I didn't just sit down and just go, okay, here it is.
Well, see, that's a problem. That's an image that I had that I didn't know that your public not necessarily knew. You have a very, I think people would be surprised that you have a very, very strong family unit. And
it's terrific.
It is, yeah. And I've heard wonderful things about it. Our next guest became the definitive Val after her climb to the top of the charts with the song Valley Girl. But who is she really? Let's meet her and find out. Moon Unit Zappa. Moon Unit, thank you for being with us. Part of the family here. You, of course, see the private image of Dad here. Is there a strong family?
Oh, certainly.
Yeah? It really is?
Yes.
I've heard that you really have a cloistered little family place there. Would you call yourself father? Is that one of the most important parts of your person,
being a
father?
Dad?
Yeah.
Well, just say I like it a lot.
We don't eat dinner together, but sure.
Just because you don't never see anybody who lives in the house, because,
everyone's splitting in different directions.
That doesn't mean you don't like each other an awful lot.
Yeah. Listen, I know you're probably up to your eyeballs with Valley Girl.
Yes.
We're talking images, and that has got to be a difficult image to get away from. Are you trying to get away from that image now?
Yes, it's very difficult. I really want to get into comedy. I'd like to do films and, maybe even Broadway. Laugh. Valley Girl for me was comedy, and it was a character that I do, and I do several characters. I really got into watching cartoons and doing voices and just, watching people on the streets and just imitating what they were doing. And that's something that I think is a lot of fun, and a lot of people misinterpreted Valley Girl and just assumed that
you
was the way I talked.
A Val, right.
Yeah.
They thought that was a real voice.
That was really an ad lib, is that right?
Yes.
What's the story on that?
We've told it so many times, it's your turn.
Actually what really happened was I had written my dad a letter, to whom it may concern. There's a kid who lives upstairs.
I see that, right.
Uh-huh. There's a kid who lives upstairs who would like to do something on the album, so if you're interested, give me a call.
Put the phone number down.
So one night he just said, well, come on down, let's do some tapes. And I just kept babbling and just had a really good time. And
then it was
right.
The rest is show business history.
Right. And you've been fighting that ever since.
Yes.
What about, were you prepared to do maybe a little other character for us?
I can't even do it anymore.
I don't mean Valley Girl.
Oh.
Another character. Something else that you like.
Well, with my girlfriend, we have this little lingo going. We're from Darrow, Indiana. We're called the God and Zisters, and we dog like this. We're geeks, and we like to go to the bony rides.
Bony rides.
The bony rides.
Yeah, so you were going to move toward acting, and do you think that the Valley Girl, certainly the notoriety, will be of help in at least getting you indoors and helping you in furthering your career?
Just the name.
Only people. If you want to go on Chips.
Yeah, people remember my name from the song, but they say, oh yeah, I remember when you were born, and that kind of thing. But other than that, no, it doesn't help at all.
Yeah, yeah. Just some questions. Yeah, get down to you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you were talking about the right that people have to use any kind of words they want. What do you think about sometimes little kids, 5, 6 years old, that, you know, talk like the word is truck drivers, you know, what do you think about that? Do you think that
what's wrong with the way truck drivers talk?
Right?
Yes, I think that you should have the right to use your native language any way that is efficient for you to get your idea across. And remember that all the words in the language have meanings, not only in the literal meaning of the word, but in the way you pronounce it and what you do with your eyebrows when you say it. And all that is part of communication. And if you deny people the total access to the type of material they need to communicate, it's not fair. If you need to get something done in a hurry, you need language that makes people do it in a hurry. So then you talk like a truck driver.
Yeah.
Okay, how did you get the name Moon Unit?
How did I get it?
Yeah.
You mean where did it, it came from up there and then through here and to there.
And I heard that you actually at one time wanted to change your name.
Something normal. I want to be named Beauty Heart.
Great. I think you're lucky you stuck with Moon Unit. Really, really. Yeah. I'm missing you. Back up in here. I want to get up to you. Yeah.
When I first heard your song, I knew it was a joke, and I knew a lot of people who talk that way. And, you know, I loved it. Do you think that you've alienated every Valley Girl in California because of the way you make fun of them?
I certainly hope so.
Yeah,
full intention, huh? Yeah.
Does your name relate to the way you dress?
Sure, I'd say I'm a funky kind of gal. My clothes aren't from Flip, by the way.
do you think the way people react to you because of your name? Do people react a little differently because of your name?
I got hassled when I was in elementary school, but you got to get tough, you know. You got to fight back.
You didn't want to go through name reduction.
Yeah. Well. You know, you're a nonconformist, and your daughter, when she made the song, a lot of people thought she was a conformist. How did you feel about that?
You asked me how I felt about the way people felt about her?
Yeah, because everybody was saying, wow, look at his daughter, you know, in my neighborhood, everybody's like that.
Mm-hmm. And you poor, unfortunate thing.
And they had all the Valley Girl contests and everything, and they were all saying, wow, she's so normal, and she has this weird father. Look at him. He's so out of style.
Yeah. Well, you see, I've never been that fond of style to begin with, but if you think about what happened with the consumption of that song, the intention of the song was one thing and the consumption was something else. The song was written to be a commentary on that type of behavior, and instead of being treated as a piece of satire, people thought, oh, here's something else dumb that we can imitate over and over and over and over again.
Yeah.
I have a question for Moon Unit. Is your dad a disciplinarian? Is he a stiff father? He seems very, very easy to me. You know, not like a 12 o'clock curfew type father.
He needs to meet all my friends, you know. but I wouldn't say that he's strict, you know. I can't imagine him.
Tell him about your curfew last night.
You can go out till all hours, but
What about guys? With guys? Are you pretty tough with a guy?
Well, I like to see who she's hanging out with, you know, because I'm an Italian dad. You know, that's what you do. You have to see who she's going out with.
What does he make him feel like? Does he give him like the up and down? You know, I mean, is it a?
No, I got radar. I don't know if he's up and down. Boom, like that. You know.
You got it. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Did you like the name Moon Unit when you were a little kid?
Yeah. No, I didn't. But.
It grows on you.
Yeah.
It does.
The more I heard it, the more I liked it.
Well, I think both of you have grown on a lot of people over the years. And I can see, I definitely believe this actress in you. I can see that there. Yeah. Good luck with that.
Thank you.
And Frank, on your other projects, I know you're doing some Broadway. You're working toward Broadway and other projects, and I look forward to seeing what other musical things happen. Thank you. Frank and Moon, you're